number three.
Hi girls, I'm Paul from Blackpool. You've heard of Blackpool Pleasure Beach. How would you like to ride the big one?
He's in great shape, there's no doubt about it. Emerald green eyes and a massive chest, a Capricorn, bold, ambitious, and has a PhD in oral sex.
None left.
Paul, you didn't save one for me. I didn't get one. What was it? What was it?
Complimentary tickets to ride the big one.
Oh my goodness, you better stay.
Phil, you're a corny top-line, tried and tested. You're a beautiful girl, and you're a bit of honesty, I'll be straight with you. Would you go out on a date with me?
Oh, I don't know. A bit forward, that's what you think.
Just a bit of honesty, nice and straight with you. I don't believe in corny top-lines.
You're just straight to the point, aren't you? Get right in there.
Yeah.
That was fairly steamy in the good one.
What do you think of him? He's a bit of a babe, isn't he? Do you think he's a bit of a babe?
I think he is.
Could you make him into a man?
Stuart asked, could you make him into a man?
Could you make him into a man?
I could.
You could.
I could. Or I could try.
He might get lucky if he's God's gift tonight. Thank you very much. Let's hear it.
Are we ready for contestant number three? Four, choose your weapon.
Armbreaker.
Armbreaker. Okay. There are buckets of sand here. Whoever can hold it for the longest wins. You've got to hold it out. Your time stops now.
They both have to hold out a bucket of sand. The devil's disciple holds it out. It weighs half a hundredweight. Can Paul hang on? Nobody has beaten the devil's disciple in this game. The bucket is beginning to drop. Paul is looking for inspiration to the audience. He's not going to drop it. I tell you, it weighs half a hundredweight. And boy, he's done it!
Okay, enough! You are brilliant. Please put the buckets of sand to the side. Thank you very much. What did you think?
Wow!
Paul is really strong, isn't he?
Well, definitely he can hold my handbag.
Hey, Paul.
Aggravation.
Okay, it's now that time again. Boys, go to your podium. Go to your podium. Girls, don't take their pants off. We'll be voting for God's gift at the end of the programme. But at this stage, the girls have got to ask themselves, who would they like to date most?
But it is, in fact, Paul number three.
Paul, we meet here atop the podium. They think you are going to defend our honour. Will we protect you on a date?
Oh yeah, certainly will.
Paul, have you spotted anyone you like?
Me. Yeah.
Who?
I'll keep that to the end.
Who is going to keep that to the end?
If I win.
Paul, you might win. You could go with one of these gorgeous girls. But let us not forget the most glamorous, the most gorgeous. We don't know who she is, only they at home. She might also be terrifying. She's a mystery date. Ask her a question.
What would be your ideal date? Sat at home with a TV, video and box chocolates, or out clubbing it, getting drunk? Yeah!
Well, I'd be at home. But we'd be watching porn on the telly and I'd be licking chocolate off your jumbo.
I've got to ask you a question. Who here would like to see these boys with their kit off?
Paul, well, he beat the devil's disciple and with deep throat on the couch.
Time for... Yeah. okay. They could be good looking, they could be strong, they could have big shoulders and bulging knees. But we're not...
Bulging what?
Knees.
Sorry.
We are not going to send you out on a date without knowing the boy's past. It's important, isn't it?
Yeah!
You need to know the worst thing they've done, don't you?
Yeah. So then we're going to see if we can...
Yeah.
So then we're going to see if we can forgive it. Are you ready for contestant number three?
Yeah.
And all my friends were telling me she'd been unfaithful to me loads of times. Like, I was getting a bit paranoid about this. So I decided to get out of town for a while, just go for a break. And I was going to go to my auntie's. And then one of my friends came to me and said one of his mates had dropped out. They're supposed to be going on a holiday to Ibiza. So I thought, you know, that sounds like a good idea. And I couldn't get all the money together in time. So I borrowed 50 quid off my girlfriend. And then she still thought I was going to Derby. I wrote her a letter. While she thought I was in a car on my way to Derby, I was on a plane on my way to Ibiza.
Could you forgive him?
No.
No way? No. Goodness me. Could you forgive any of them?
None of them.
Well, you're going to have to choose one because you will be voted for God's gift at the end of the programme, but you've got to ask yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You could date one of these gorgeous girls.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, got the giggles. Or you could date the mystery date. We do not know who she is. Only they at home. She could be your biggest wet dream. Ask her a question.
If I was to meet you on a blind date, how would you describe yourself?
Well, I'd be the one in the ready position.
Because it's time for, oh yes, you guessed it, another date! The boys have gone off to their positions. Now, what was it about Adam?
He's gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. We love him.
We love him a bit.
I don't believe his story.
Yeah, well, like,
don't
believe his story. I am speaking. Do you not think it's very important? Wonder part, it's fun. Do you not think it's very important that the boys are funny? Yeah. They're on the date, they make you laugh. They've got to make you laugh, haven't they?
Yeah. Yeah. They're all men.
You think all men make you laugh?
Yes, they're very funny.
They're very funny. Yeah. Well, you're going to decide who's the funniest out of our four boys because they're ready to go. It's contestant number four, isn't it, Stuart?
Yes. Adnan advances on stage. He's doing strange things with his body with a member of our audience. Oh, my word. This could lead to a very steamy sequel in Hell's Cockpit. And remember this, this is a culture show. It's all about brains and wit and intelligence. Please.
Wait. I just want to ask something. You're in a bad mood and you need to be cheered up. Your boyfriend's going to say, don't worry, darling, I'll put a bow tie on, a pair of glasses, and you can put baby oil all over me. Adnan, where did this idea come from?
Desperation.
Desperation. Let's hear it for Adnan. Yeah. Who's on next, Stuart?
Finally, Paul is going to make a baby.
I'm sorry, I've changed your baby's vacuum.
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. Not making a baby. He's already had one. He's changing the nappy. It's pretty obvious he's never done it before in his life. If you go down to the woods today, you're sure of a big surprise. It's Paul with a giant teddy bear.
Okay, no.
Well, it was a good effort.
It was a good effort.
Good effort.
It was entertaining.
I knew it was so fascinating.
Yeah, we like that. Paul, thank you very much. Go back to your podium. They can go back to their podium. Now, who are you going to vote for?
Paul.
Now, why is it?
Why? Because he's good. He's a darling.
He's a darling. Now, yeah. What about you?
Paul.
And Paul as well. Yeah. All right, well, let me tell you, girls, you'll be voted for God's gift at the end of the programme. Don't make up your minds yet. But you've got to ask yourself, at this stage, who would you like to date most?
Girls, please listen up. You're out on the date. You're dying to have a laugh. Which one of our young bucks would make you laugh until you cry? Prepare to stand by your man. Is it Adnan with oil in his body? Liam Scorpio Dance, Scott in his tutu, or Paul with his teddy bear? And it is, it's number one, Leo.
Oh yes, this is the most exciting moment, almost, of all, because the boys have been strong, they've been charming, they've done scorpion dances, but what do their pectorals look like? The boys are going to strip!
Oh no! It's gyration time, boys. It's kit-off time. But remember, this is a culture show. We are looking for God's gift, not on groom, but on brains. But the girls demand it, so we give the girls what they want. And the kit comes off. A variety of miscellaneous underwear. Oh, it's press-up time. Oh, there's been some bonding. The males are bonding. They're not competing. They've all come together. Oh, Adnan. Oh. Well, I think Leon is determined to show everything that he's got. Remember, he's the chef with the coq au vin. I think the exhibition is now finished.
Enough. Didn't you love that, Stuart? The fact that they'd organised a little routine.
Yes, I love it. A bit of male bonding.
We love your routine and we love your pants. Exhibit. Boys, go to your podiums. Oh, go on. Off you go. Off you go. Go and stand on your podium. Girls, let me tell you something. You will be voting for God's gift at the end of the programme. But at this stage, you've got to ask yourself the question, haven't you? Who would you like to date most?
Ladies, settle down, wipe the sweat from your brow. Because I ask you, which one of our guys' bodies actually melted your panties clean away? Prepare to stand by your men! And the rush, the concerted rush, is really on now. They're all standing there like Greek gods, awaiting the garland. It is number three, it's Paul!
Excuse me, excuse me.
Oh, are they pulling your pants down?
They are.
Oh, my goodness. Do you love him?
Lovely.
Yeah? Look at his tummy.
Lovely.
Okay, stop it, enough. No, leave him alone. Now, let me tell you something. You could date one of these rather rampant girls, or you could opt for the mystery date. Why don't you answer a question?
Question. On a romantic night in, what love song would you put on?
Okay.
Well, hopefully I'll be there in the morning, so it'd be Forest Gardeners, I Wanna Wake Up With You.
Like it? Like it a lot?
Like it.
All right, well, you think you're going to be God's gift, don't you?
Definitely.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? They all think they're going to be God's gift, and they're going to try and convince us after the break.
Ooh.
I say again to it, ooh. Well, in the next 10 minutes, we're going to find out who's tonight's God's gift. Indeed we are. But Stuart, tell me, how are they doing?
It's a lovely cameo sitting on the street. They're all handsome. They're all up for it. They're all great. Leon, the sex and food lad, that birthday card cake with the pubes, a large coq au vin later boy. Scott, oh, insulted the DD. The bum is so fat you've got skid marks on the ceiling, but he was divine in his tutu. Paul, you unfaithful boy. £50 off a girlfriend, decamping to Ibiza, and these deep throat too. And Adnan, well, he's heart of Stevie, the Yul Brynner of our boys. But he was a real man in the wrestling ring. It's difficult to pick a God's gift. They're all four are God's gift, Claudia.
They're all wonderful. But before we pick them, it's time for a final test. Well, these boys, they all think they're God's gift, obviously. They think they should be picked tonight. We have generously given them 30 seconds to try and persuade the audience that they are God's gift. That's fair, isn't it?
Yes.
That's fair. Are we going to be... It's sporting. Are we ready for contestant number three?
Well, girls, I'm not claiming to be the best looking, the best dressed, the best dancer, or to have the best body. But what I can tell you is I'm a good all-rounder. I've got good looks, good body, got charm, and I'll have a good time if you vote.
Find out who is God's gift. I've got you these fantastic Prussian red velvet lucky bags. Take them. They should have your contestant number. Make sure that it's right. That's yours. Yeah. All the girls have got little red love hearts. Let's have a look at them. And what you boys are going to do is go into the audience and get as many as you can, and then you go backstage with Stuart Counselman. Are you ready?
Yeah.
How do you feel? Confident?
Yeah,
you're loving it. Yeah, you?
Getting there
and Adnan.
Wishing.
You're wishing. Boys, go claim your love token.
They rush into the audience and this is going to be a very difficult choice. All four have sparkled in all the rounds. Leon's won a couple, Paul's won one, Adnan's won one. Going by Paul's won two. But it's all about, it's all an amalgam of your wit and your charm, your ability to take girls out, give them a good time. And then, of course, it's all on the shape of your body. But we don't dwell on that one.
We do not. Boys, you go backstage now. Adnan, Leon, go on, you go backstage now. They're going backstage. Who did you vote for?
Of course, Paul.
Paul. Really?
Paul?
Who did you vote for?
Leon.
Leon.
He's so gorgeous.
It's gorgeous. Okay.
It's gorgeous.
Well, you girls could go on a date with him.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
We don't know who's going to win. We'll get the results. But do you want to have a look at last week's date in the meantime?
Yeah.
Go on then, yeah.
Last week's lovers flew British Airways First Class to Australia, where they ventured across the Great Barrier Reef and frolicked in the Aussie surf. And after a relaxing kangaroo trek, they watched the sun slowly set.
So, Stuart has the result.
We do have the result. There are the boys still bonding on the back lot. Let's go through them. Adnan, a real speech from the heart in the pulpit there. Wunderbra lift, lightning and thunder, the Yul Brynner of our time. And Paul, fine, upright, strong boy, showed enterprise in nipping off to Ibiza with his girlfriend, Dosh. Scott, another honorable boy, super sport, the last of the Corinthians. He praised the three other great guys. But in the pulpit, Leon. Guaranteed a good time. Pastor and wine, you could be mine. And the pew birthday cake made him God's gift tonight.